So I've been trying to expand my horizons regarding what systems I test out. There are going to be a few reasons why I haven't tested out the analog pocket, which include the price, the fact that at first there wasn't a way of inserting your own ROMs through a micro SD card until recently, and the availability overall. So today I'm testing out a device that is kind of similar, but ultimately one that really left me hanging. Granted, this is coming from someone that has tested a ton of retro handhelds that allow you to use your own ROMs, and devices that are much cheaper too, so there is a reason why I'm having such a strong reaction. Frankly, I don't know what I was expecting. Maybe that I would love the hardware enough to justify the price or the experience as it is, but introducing the Evercade Blaze EXP, a waste of my money. Let's dive right in. So right off the bat, the exterior design of this device is really good. We have a hefty construction that is comprised of plastic, but it feels really good and comfortable in hand. It does feel like a really nice built device, and I have to commend them for the attention to detail here. On the front, you will find your usual buttons, which actually feature an Xbox layout instead of Nintendo, and there are even A and B buttons for vertical play if you want that, which is actually really cool. There are no thumbsticks though. On the top, you're going to find a set of shoulder buttons, a mini HDMI port, a sleep-wake button, and a cartridge slot. On the bottom, you're going to find a USB-C port, a headphone jack, turbo button, volume controls, and stereo speakers. So I also wanted to give them some more credit here and say that the buttons, all of them, feel really nice. The D-pad feels great with fantastic rolling capabilities, and there is a good amount of resistance when pressing any of the face buttons. Even the triggers feel great to press, so I have to commend them on their attention to detail once more. This will undoubtedly make for a great gaming experience. This device features an 800x480 IPS display that does look pretty decent. It's definitely not the best screen out there due to the lack of saturation and the colors, which does mean that the colors do look a little bit dull for my taste, but it does look pretty sharp, and it's definitely plenty high res for what you will be playing on this device, which is actually kind of a shame to say and should speak to the limitations of what this device can ultimately accomplish. When it comes to the speakers, you do get a stereo set of speakers, which on paper sounds like it should sound pretty great, but in practice these speakers sound pretty bad. They don't get very loud at all, sounds a little bit tinny to me, and are very lackluster overall. I expected better, and seeing this was very disappointing, so have a listen. Now when it comes to the UI, this is when people, I think, will really appreciate what's here, since we just have a UI that is incredibly simple and made for making game selection much simpler, which I really appreciate. Sure, it's not running Android or anything like that, but this interface works great for what it is meant to accomplish. So I actually really like it, and I do wish that more retro handhelds included an interface like this. Now when it comes to the game selection, you get 18 games built in onto the system and 6 games that come from the included iRAM cartridge, for a total of 24 games. However, this is a cartridge-based system, and they make other bundles that include games from different developers such as Intellivision, Morphcat Games, Jellico, Gale Code, Atari, and more. The ones included with this device are Capcom games, along with that iRAM cartridge that I mentioned. So the intention with this device is very clear. It's meant to play these specific retro titles, and obviously, it's not meant to emulate systems like the NES, SNES, PlayStation 1, and the like. But this, to me, was kind of the downfall of this device. However, how does this device actually perform? Well, I tested some games on it and found that they all ran really well, as I think that these games are really nicely optimized for this system, or the other way around, where this system is just well optimized for these games. I'll give you some examples. Mega Man X ran really well. Street Fighter 2 was a joy as well. Breath of Fire was a new experience for me, and I appreciate it for what it is. R-Type from the cartridge was an experience, I suppose. But my point with all of this is that these games got old for me pretty quickly. And the fact that the system is so limited to playing these arcade games, it makes it very difficult to truly make this a portable gaming device for me. I can pick it up, play for a few minutes, and then get bored afterwards, but that's mostly just me, you know? And with each cartridge costing roughly $25, this is a pretty expensive device to keep useful. This is meant to serve a certain crowd, and I do understand that, but it just seems pretty difficult to justify. I'm not complaining about the games being too old, but just too short to really retain my attention, and I can't do much about it considering the limitations of this device. You're kind of stuck with these games as is. This device has a battery that should last you around 4 hours pretty easily, which is perfectly reasonable as is. I don't have any qualms regarding the battery life. In fact, the game's selection and the limitations here are what really have me pretty down about this device, especially considering the price. So I just wanted to say that this device is pretty cool on paper, but I don't think that my audience will ultimately be interested in it because of the many limitations I mentioned. And it is a shame too, because the hardware is really good, and I would love to see Evercade try something like that. Clearly, I prefer games emulation through the many other devices available in the market. So to me, this device isn't worth it because of how expensive it is to properly support with more games and the little interest that I have personally in the games shown, quite frankly. So no, this isn't for me. But I would also argue that those other devices are much better for people who want to emulate arcade games anyway, because they allow for a lot more flexibility. If you've got ROMs of your own to install, then you've got an even bigger game selection too. So the Evercade Blaze EXP was a waste of my money, and I don't recommend it, but I will leave a playlist with plenty of videos about many different retro handhelds, and there is actually a video dedicated to reviewing briefly every single handheld that I own, so I will leave that linked in a pinned comment as well. Hopefully this will help you make a decision on what to get. However, it is worth noting that there are a lot of positive reviews on Amazon for this, which tells me that I'm just not the audience for this device. I just want to clarify that it isn't a bad device, or that the concept is just bad in practice, because it isn't. Just not what I wanted, and this experience couldn't change my mind in the end. So thank you so much for watching this video all the way up until the end. I do very much appreciate it. And if you are still interested in getting the Evercade XP, or EXP, and you just want to prove me wrong on how this device is just absolutely amazing in every way, I will leave an affiliate link down below. By all means, make sure to use that. And I do genuinely want to hear your comments and your thoughts down below as well, because maybe I could have looked at this device from a different angle. Your feedback is also very important, so I would appreciate your comments down below in case I missed anything or if I missed the mark on this review. Also, I do have a Twitch where you can find me and ask me questions live, and I have an Instagram where you can also find me and ask me questions live, but it would just take a lot longer for me to get back to you that way. But I do post every now and then. But with that said, this has been Francisco from Tech Summit. Thank you for watching, and until next time, enjoy.